17 connect to 80 and all that shit.
I'll just roll one up and I'll put it over there.
Alright, we are. I'll just start this out.
Nah, this is dope, man. How long have you been doing the podcast?
It's been a year.
Oh, dope.
Yeah, it's dope. Been a year. It's been last year, November, during the pandemic.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I always wanted to do it, but I always was like, I'm not prepared. You know what I mean? I was second guessing everything. Hold on.
Yeah, no doubt.
I was second guessing everything. Because I overthink everything. You know what I mean? I overthink every you are in the middle.
Oh, okay.
You know, I try to keep the guess right in the middle. See if I make sure. Yeah. Make sure everything right. But what I try to do is I had an idea for it. Mm-hmm. I actually had an idea to do the pod. The pod was pretty much based off of me and my homegirl, like, talking about relationship situations, which it was going to be called Pussy Popping on the Podcast. Just a little flip on words, mm-hmm. line that I had came up with. And you know what I mean? You could throw that into some other stuff, you know?
Right.
So that was my whole idea. But then when it didn't come together, and I'm the type of person, like, if my plan don't come together, I get discouraged by it, and I don't want to, like...
Go revisit it.
Yeah. It's like, it didn't work. So... Off to something else, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, this motherfucker that's about to come, the one, a VA, the one, John, the one that ain't been here for a while,
mm-hmm.
he about to come through.
Okay.
And he was like, yo, you got to do something. So I was like, all right, let's just put the pod together. So we just started it last year,
mm-hmm.
right here in November. It's funny because he had his camera and I had just recorded off my phone just to have some backup.
Right.
And when we first did the episode, we couldn't get it off of his, something was wrong with where it was on the laptop or something. We couldn't get it.
Mm-hmm.
So I just said, fuck it. And I just threw it out. I threw out mine.
Mm-hmm.
And mine is like, got the, you see how the phone is on the wall.
Right.
My phone wasn't there. My phone was
lower.
Yeah, it was looking through the wall.
Yo.
But I said, fuck it. Mm-hmm. So I just threw it out there. And then the next episode we got right. And then we threw that out there. And I just kept doing it. And mm-hmm. then I started adding guests to the show. You know what I mean? Because sometimes, like, the dynamic isn't just hitting the way I wanted to hit.
Right.
Look so at
right.
that. Busy man.
It's just
yeah. Yo, if y'all, I ain't even start the show yet. But this is a legend I'm sitting by right here. This is a living legend. He's like the Dr. Dre of underground, if I may say. Can I say something like that?
I'm gonna
gas you, nigga.
I mean,
he's like the doc. Listen, I could say that shit because I was there to witness all the shit. I was watching some old videos and stuff. I was there to witness a lot of things that you did, and a lot of people that were like kind of came under you and who you affected, and I got in the beat battles because y'all was in beat battles. If I didn't go in the beat battles, I wouldn't have got better at producing.
Wow.
Mm-mm. I was so stuck in, like, I used to make beats. My beats used to be like, because of course I started and I did the PlayStation.
Mm-hmm.
So I just had a thing for like sounds.
Right.
It was always sounds. I don't give a fuck. Like, oh, that's a hot sound. Oh, mm-hmm. that's a hot riff.
Mm-hmm.
And then the whole freaking song or beat will be around the sound. You right. know how most producers be like, yo, they structure it by the drums first or bass line first. I was backwards as hell. Like, I was just like sound and like percussion and shit. Like, the drums would be all over the place, and the bass line I never added. When niggas said, where's the bass? I was like, what? I wasn't even thinking like that. Because mm-hmm. I'm a, my whole musical influence is like orchestra, like scores and shit.
Right.
Like I grew up on like E.T. theme music, John Williams, you know what I mean? Who's the other motherfucker that did Beetlejuice? Forget the dude, the composer's name. But, Elfman, like, mm-hmm. I grew up on that, so just like the sounds of it was what I was really into.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to like backtrack and go, all right, how I structured drums, how I structured the bass. So I had to backtrack. by going into beat battles, that also taught me I have to sample, right? And I have to learn how to chop them motherfuckers.
Right, right.
Because I remember I was watching one of you, you had just did somebody else's pod. I can't remember the dude's name, but y'all just did someone's pod like maybe a month ago.
Right.
And y'all was talking about loops.
Yeah.
He was talking about how, yeah, loop is like the lazy way, but you were saying, but most of the classic songs you hear are straight loops.
Yeah, one bar loops.
Yeah. And I'm like, yeah, you're right, because if the loop is hot, then you're just going to keep swinging that shit around. Mm-hmm. I know you're more into like, I'm going to get a loop, but I'm going to fucking demolish that shit into little pieces.
Yeah,
and then I'm going to structure it back again. And then I'm going to, like, play something over it. You know what I mean?
And then on top of that, too, even when I did that.
I like how people be doing that. They be watching it while.
Yeah.
But.
Damn. So, like, yeah, man. It's. It was just, I don't know, man. I don't know. Like, just like you, I think out the box. Like, I don't think, like.
Okay, so. I guess let me start just before we jump. Like, I could start from the beginning.
Yeah.
But can I start from where I came in? Because I know you a little personally than other people. All right, so it was like 99, 96, 90.
I would say 98, 99.
Around that bracket. Because that's when. Because 97 is when I was out in the Bronx all the time with France. France is my godbrother. So I'm with him. He owned one place.
Right.
That's how I go to Andrews Ave, right across, right around, and that's how I meet Impact.
Okay.
And that's from Impact. I lose because I know from Impact that's how I met R&R. I remember when I met R&R in Red's living room. We went to Red's. I think we was at Red's house.
Right.
And he was freestyling around.
Right. And that's what he did. Yeah, that's what Smarty Pants did that old.
It's Smarty. That's where he said, no disrespect to DMX, but this is when he said, you hear one DMX song, you hear them all. It was something like that.
Yeah, I remember that bar from him. Then he kicked that
metaphor. I don't know how he got that.
And then he kicked that metaphor line.
Which one? Who? Who you talking about? Smarty?
Yeah, that's when he kicked that.
Oh, well, that's why I met him?
Yeah, I was like, wow.
You know how many times after that you heard niggas say something like
And I heard that back in 99, so that was just a...
Yeah. That's back when you was trying every line you wanted to get a... Ooh, facts. That's what I grew up on. Facts. So it was 98, 99. Had to be in that bracket.
Yeah.
Because DMX was rocking that time, and I remember R was just like, anybody that was rocking, he wasn't really fucking with like that.
Yeah.
Shout out to R. But, yeah, I think that's around the time we met, and at this time, I'm not making beats. I guess yes, because 99 is when I think I got the first PlayStation beat music generator. And that's when I started just making sound effect beats and shit like that.
Yo, before you go on, yo, I was really impressed on how you was able to make beats on a PlayStation. Like, never heard. I never saw it.
But all right, you never saw it. But all right, for someone like you, like, and you're an NPC baby. Can I say that? Like,
yeah, I started from the NPC.
NPC, because from what I understand, you started on a 3000, right?
Yeah.
All right, and then you went back. Oh, that's when the 2500, right? I remember that.
Yeah.
And certain ones had certain things added. So, what the fuck am I talking about? So, you're NPC, baby. So, all right, when I was doing the PlayStation beat generator, a little bit after that is where you get,
Come around the back.
Yo!
The weed, man.
I knew you. Oh, Jesus. I'm gonna have to hold that point. Don't fuck up shit, nigga.
Nah, my bad.
Come around if you gonna bust through like a fucking Kool-Aid man and shit. I gotta hold that point, because I'm gonna say, I know where I'm at with your NPC thing.
Right.
But this one.
Yo, what up, boss?
It's fun too.
That's John.
How you doing?
DJ Static.
DJ Scotty?
No, Static.
Static.
Oh my God. You starting wrong.
Good toxic.
Say hello to the fucking people. You ain't been here for 12 years.
A little intoxicated.
Nah, so you don't need to eat or drink anything. I mean, you don't need to drink or smoke anything.
Nah, we good. I'm going to get y'all right.
No. Watch the wires.
My bad.
Yeah, watch that, please.
Hello, everybody.
Oh, my God. You come in here with that dirty-ass paper of yours. You know I'm a royal family, boys.
Nah, baby. We smoking that shit. What you
mean? I ain't smoking that shit. I like my lungs, nigga.
Come on. Let's get back to it, dog.
No. Are we on here? Oh, yeah, this nigga.
Yeah, we on here.
All right, so say hi, Jonathan.
Hello, everybody.
Ask him where the fuck you been. You were supposed to be here last week. You were supposed to be here last show.
A little bit of hiatus, you know.
He got families and shit.
Yeah, bro.
I think multiple.
We're gonna get into that.
It's a joke, nigga.
We're gonna get into that a little later.
It's a joke. It was really a joke.
Yeah, my bad. All right, come on, let's continue.
Continue. Yeah. You know what you're doing. You see what the homework is up there. Study. It's right. Different out here. I have to have organization. I just can't have a super duper free flowing wave. Unless I'm doing it.
I see something talking about some pussy.
Where you see the pussy at?
You said vaginal?
No, this is virgil. Nigga.
Oh, yeah. What's up? Yo.
We're not going to go into virgil right now. Hold that thought. Yeah. All the current events, we're going to go to you for. And see what you going to kill on the current events.
No, but did you see the 3-6 joint?
I was just watching it. But it was
playing in 2 seconds.
But you know what? Real quick, the 3-6.
Yeah.
The 3-6 shit, he wouldn't have threw the bottle, but because whatchamacallit says suck my dick.
Oh, I ain't hear.
That's what triggered him, because I think they was doing some, the song they was doing.
Who said suck my dick?
Juicy J. He said it twice.
White boy shit, because you know that shit don't fly in the hood.
Yeah,
listen, that shit don't fly in upstate.
Upstate.
Downstate.
It don't fly when you around motherfuckers, like, that could get you hurt.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, they sang some, like, doo-wop-ish type of song. Whatever it was, it was more, like, all them in unison. And I guess these niggas was making fun of them. At least that's what Busy was saying. Mm-hmm. So Busy comes up like, yo, y'all ain't gonna be mocking me, blah, 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 blah. And then Juicy just like, yo, suck my dick.
I heard he threw a bottle.
That's when he threw the joint. But... he's the bad guy because he threw the joint.
I think that shit was all set up anyway. He was like, yo, my nigga, I'm going to throw this bottle at you. We're going to get these ratings.
Nah.
That's how it is.
Nah. Stop.
I'm just saying how the beef goes.
Come here talking about what...
The beef is fake. It's always fake.
Didn't you just go out and eat?
Shout out to No Shades, man. Them drinks is official. that shit got me twazzled.
Twazzled? That's a whole new world. That's a word. I'm like, twazzled? That's word. Like twat and twit all together. All right.
Got me arguing.
Hold on. I was getting into the feel of some shit. I was talking
to you. Tell me, continue. All
right, thank you. So, bust it. Like you said, you didn't understand how, like, I could, figure out the PlayStation like that, right?
Like how, how everything came.
Oh, so right. How he made the beats.
Yeah. So just to backtrack, when I first started making beats, he was like the dude that was making beats in the area, right? He was one of the main dudes. So I said, without him doing like his beats and doing the beat battles, because I got excited when he was doing. I was like, oh, when I went to one of them, I was like, oh, all right. It's like a show, but you're just doing it with your beats. And you're not just playing it. Because, see, the beat battles y'all got now is bullshit. I'm going to be 100. Y'all play a loop with a drum track for 2 minutes or a minute. And if that's hot enough, it wins. The beat battles that we did was you had to give these niggas a show. Mm-hmm. Like, you had to give a motherfucker. You couldn't just play a beat. Like, you had 2 minutes to get the crowd's attention and keep it. So what you had to do was like you had to play like maybe a lot of people would play little excerpts of acapellas or vocals. Like I'm gonna whip your ass. Da, 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 da. We would what I chop up the Matrix shit. You just what you chop up? You chop up some. What was one of your known beats, bro?
I guess war.
Yeah, I had flipped that too, but it was different. I had flipped that too, but his war. But you did war. What you? R didn't do war. What the R did? R did something.
Nah, he did something else, but he didn't do war.
He didn't do war.
Yeah, he didn't do war. Shout out to R and R too.
Yeah. But basically, what I was saying, the way I struggled, like the PlayStation, I was always good at video games when I was a kid. So being a video game head, just trying to figure out how I could master and structure it was one of my things. But if you look at early Fruity Loops, it's just a precursor to early Fruity Loops. It's just a bigger blocks than the Fruity Loops ones, and it's easier to like structure, like follow it. You know what I mean? That's all it was.
So we're talking about making beats with your PlayStation.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Because that's one of the reasons I told him I got into beat battling, because of him.
Can you still do that? This PlayStation 5 out. Can you still?
Yeah, I mean, you could, like, but everything's on your computer. You do that now. When we started,
it wasn't
making beats on a computer was not the thing.
Program, yeah.
It was MPCs. It was SPs.
ASRs.
Early 90s shit, right?
Yeah. To mid 90s shit, yeah. Right. It was none of that until you get to the late 90s, early 2000s is when you get the early 2000s. When did Ninth Wonder? Because Ninth Wonder was like the known dude.
Ninth Wonder came in like in the 2000s.
Early 2003? No.
Probably like.
Didn't he have something for Encore?
He did.
That's
04.
He was on that Black album.
That's the Black album,
right? Yeah. That's 04. Yeah. That's 04. Wow. He's right after. Cause you gotta think, I'm doing a generator. Fruity Loops is right after that, and then Reason is right after that. And I remember when it came out, y'all was like, "Yeah, it's cute, but it had no weight to it." Remember, you don't have to wait like the NPC, but, you know, all the music got weightless now, so it doesn't even matter. Like, it's a different texture you want to get.
People are making them longer songs now, like, making a whole long joint. Like, how many? I'm not too familiar.
I think they doing that. You're talking about albums. I think they doing that for the streams.
Yeah, exactly.
They doing that. They making, like, double, quadruple albums because it's for the streams. It's not for, the quality of the fucking...
Because people are reposting, and it's always going to be up there. They're getting free.
Kanye came out with pretty much a double album and then came out with a deluxe of that. He got like 30-something on the deluxe. So it's like, it's all about generating, this one, spin it. Because the streams are so low. You're getting what out of a stream? It takes you like... damn near a billion streams to get like $1 million. Some shit like, and that, like, it doesn't make any kind of sense.
I'm planning to look into all of that, man. How to monetize and do all that, because that shit is real.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but like I was saying, that's what got me into B-Battling. That what's got me. And I think the real reason why you probably was really impressed, because I could have made beats, because remember, it was me. Bad Sport was nice. Bad Sport was like... Bad Sport was kind of like the Yoda of it.
What was he from?
Bad Sport was in our crew. He was rapping.
Bergen County?
Yeah. I met him at PCF. He used to work at PCF.
What is that?
That's a call center spot. Oh. And he was funny at work that. Met him there. He's from Inglewood. And he was just like this little short Spanish dude that was just like...
Nice.
But he was nice. And he was hella passionate. He's still, I don't know what he's doing, but he's hella passionate. And he was always into beats and da 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 da. So he would take a sound that I got and would morph it into something else. And I was like, bro, how the fuck? That's too much. Just give me the sample. I'll chop it. I'll layer this drum on this drum to make it heavier. Like, you know what I mean? I had certain ways of doing it.
Right.
But my thing was, it was the reasons why we probably stuck out is because we was more creative. Mm-hmm. We figured, like, all right, this is all we got to use. So we're going to use it to the best of my ability. That's why I stopped using it. I extinguished it. There's nothing else I could have done.
I was on, I'm not sorry. But
go ahead, talk.
Sorry, talk about the talk about the creativeness. I was listening to, like, Chopped and Screwed the other day, and it brought me back, yo. We used to really bump that.
Mm. He a Southern boy.
Oh, okay.
He from VA, so that's why, you know what I mean?
Fucking Boss Hog.
Yeah. He's some... What's my man from Houston? You some tall ass with the braids.
Slim Thug?
Yeah, yo, some Slim Thug ass.
Yeah, Boss Hall Outlaws, man. But I'm saying, like, there's a lot of creative shit.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, you just gotta
you gotta have that vision.
Just like this. Listen, this is a phone. Ain't no, it's sideways. These niggas is looking at it, okay? I'll flip it when it's done. You know what I mean? But it's a fucking phone. It's doing its job right now. I don't have all the technology in the world right now, so I'm using this to get me to the next plateau on it. So that's basically it. But bro, how you feel? I've been talking a lot. Hey, everybody, this is Attention Horse Podcast. How the fuck y'all doing? No, I didn't, nigga. I was waiting for your punk ass. We was already talking. Man. We was getting into some shit.
Yeah, man.
This is the legendary DJ Static. Yeah, I think you said hi already. But what's going on, brother? What you been up to lately?
A lot and nothing at the same time.
It seems as though.
Yo, word, bro.
You know what I'm saying? It's just a lot of nothing. But it's, you know, for right now for me, I've been posting a lot of remixes. So
I seen that's like your thing to do right now.
Yeah, it's my thing to do at this point. Yeah, I mean, I'm just having fun. You know what I'm saying?
I think you get to a point too where, especially you're pretty much, I think you're solidified in what you could do. Like, this man has been through the ranks. He's produced for legends. He's produced for, I believe you have something coming out with KRS-One, or you have stuff with KRS-One.
Yeah, actually, the last video, like that little short film that he did, I actually did two joints on there.
Mm.
One of them he was freestyling for a while, and then there was one that he did in the car. So when he was in the car driving from the gas station, that's the one I produced. And then when they got into the studio, the first beat that he did, like a good, like, 10-minute freestyle, that was the beat I produced as well.
Okay. And of course, my favorite MC of all time, Redman.
Oh yeah, Redman. I've done co-production on Smack the Shit Out You,
which was one of the things. yeah.
And I did it was like a 3-song EP.
Yeah.
So I did.
It came out last year or the year before?
Yeah, last year.
Okay.
So I did the first. So I produced the first song. It's a banger. That was the Rockwilder flip.
Yeah, you flipped that.
And then I co-produced with Redman, Smack the Shit Out of Me.
Okay. Okay, you've done that. And then of course, you've worked under the management of a very known individual, I believe, Matthew Knowles.
Is that correct? Yeah.
I mean, I'm throwing the names out. I'm trying to get the spice.
Who is that?
Matthew Knowles, yeah. Sir. You're a Southern boy. Think of whose last name is Knowles. Yeah.
I already know, man. Stop trying to call me out, bro. You know what I'm saying?
I need my punching bag.
I just have to clarify before I just
No, you too. Oh, listen, let me get this right. What?
Yeah, man, no, it's the old lady, man. She wanna play games tonight, so we ain't playing
games. She's watching the show.
I know.
She's watching to see what the fuck.
Why you wanna fuck with me? Don't make me go crazy on this podcast.
Yeah. So like I was saying, how was that experience?
It was just an experience. It came
in. When I heard about that, I was like, what the fuck is that?
To be honest, I didn't even know that when it first started, I didn't even know. Like, I thought he was bullshit.
I thought
he was bullshitting, like, as far as, like, he just called me up while I was making beats.
Oh, he called you himself?
He called me himself, right.
Like, hello, this is Matthew Knowles. Can I speak to, I don't want to say your government, you know.
He asked for Static. He was like, you know Static, you know? I was like, yeah. Like,
you could have been any nigga called Static at that point.
Exactly. So I was just like,
yeah, I'm Static, what do you mean?
Well, like, and this was, like, a couple years ago?
Yeah, this is, like, back in
2006.
Yeah, like 2006.
Damn, fresh off the battles too, right? Because the battles started dying out around 6-7, right?
Nah, I say 5.
5 was a pimp. No. Yeah. Like 4 and 5 was like the top.
Yeah.
You're right.
So it was 2005, and then
and that was right when I started came to Jersey.
Yeah. And then for me it was just like, yo, like I said, I was in the crib. You know, doing what I do, and I get a call. It's like, hey, this Matthew Knowles, such and such. I want to congratulate you on your placement for what? I'm like, placement?
What?
I'm like, yo. It's like, yeah, I'm going to have my manager call. I mean, one of my managers reach out to you. I was like, what the fuck going on? I'm like, all right, whatever. So his manager called me like 10 minutes later.
Oh, Well, that's efficiency.
Yeah. I know his name is Jake McKim. You know, shout out to Jake McKim.
Y'all, Jake McKim, look out for him, motherfucker.
And you know, he told me the real deal. He's like, yeah, well, you know, Solange just wrote a record to one of your beats, and we got this group Trinity 5-7, the gospel group, that's gonna actually record it. And I was like, okay, that's really good.
You got to kind of mix up in a little secular shit, then.
Yeah, so yeah, it was different,
man.
It was different.
You got him. Should I do this? Or should I,
But isn't that a little easy as a producer? Because he's a producer. Like, yeah. He's structured. He knows how to. I put up there beat making against production because there's a difference. Anybody can make a beat.
Yeah.
Right? But being a producer, you're basically building the song. You know what I mean? You're like
that vision.
Yeah. You're like the blueprint to the song. Everything else, like even the vocals or the rhymes are layers to it. Mm-hmm. But you're seeing, all right, this is it. The hook is going to go there. You should do this here, a bridge.
So you already have the blueprint. You already have the experience. Mm-hmm. You just need something to work with. Right.
Yeah. So he knows that. So it's not like just, like, if I just made a beat, it's like, all right, I made a beat. I don't know what to do with it. Mm-hmm. Like, every time I made a beat, you have some kind of idea of who it should be, who it kind of fits.
I got you.
What you could do with
it. Work around that voice and work around that talent.
Yeah.
Word,
yeah.
That's what's up, man.
So, yeah, man.
Production's like painting.
So after that placement, I actually heard the song. It's a beautiful song. It's called Like You. It's by Trinity 5-7. Like I said, Solange Knowles wrote it. Yeah, and then...
Is that on a project?
Yeah, it's actually on a project. It's on the Trinity 5-7 project that... I forgot the name of the title of the album. It's been a while.
Mm-hmm.
But it's on YouTube. You can find it. It's called Like You.
Okay.
By Trinity 5-7. And then, you know, from there, I got signed to Matthew Knowles just off of that one joint. And,
What song? This is what I'm talking about. He knew one joint. Have you ever had a bad day? Yes, I want to ask you.
Yeah, I have.
You had? No. All right.
Like, have a bad day.
In music land.
Yeah, I have.
Okay. We all have bad days.
Yeah, like, you know, I had a hard drive. I went, you know, shout out to my man Maestro, because he was a music maestro. I'm going to shout out him, because he was there when it happened.
You lost it?
Not even. I had my laptop, and I had my hard drive that I stored a lot of my beats on.
Oh, that's
and then one day, the shit just dropped, and then my hard drive just did not.
You don't...
Wait, wait, wait.
I dropped the hard drive.
You don't understand as a...
But no, you're good.
Bro, no. Hard drive, you don't understand. Did you see the Wu-Tang series? You don't understand the pain... As a producer
of losing your material,
my nigga,
couldn't you like? Cause I took the hard drive out of a laptop that was damaged, so like
it was no saving it, bro.
Damn,
no saving.
Yeah, I know. If it was like, that damaged, it was over.
That's like your life savings and shit. Yeah,
if it was that damaged, it's over with.
Yeah, it was a wrap after that. So you know, and I told myself like, shit, that's a lot of beats gone, but you know I can make more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was God telling you to
wake up and do better. Like,
okay.
Do better.
Since we're on that real quick, because I'm all scattered and can't see all that. So, I knew this guy 20 years. And I always seemed like, this is me. Mm-hmm. Always seemed like he fuck with me, but he ain't fuck with me.
Cause he was on here.
No, I'm getting some shit off. This some shit. This some shit. Like I ain't never told. Tell him.
Okay.
But just tell me if I'm wrong. And I know that because back then, I mean, I'm an asshole now. Let's be 100. I know
you
niggas.
Always been an asshole.
Yes.
His middle name is asshole. But go ahead.
I know you motherfuckers all day on the gram, and I know that. But that's my talent to annoy people. So. Back then, I used to do that on purpose. Like, real purpose. Just for attention. Attention whores us, whatever the fuck. I would be the dude like, yo, hear this. Hear this, right? I would run up on niggas. I wouldn't give a fuck. I just wanted you to hear my shit.
But that's how you gotta be.
True. But there's a way about going. And I always went about it the wrong way. Yo,
tell them about how DJ Envy used your shit for a coaster.
I told that story before. Elmo.
Oh, yeah.
Elmo story.
Yo, he got
hurt. But he played it. But he played it.
Word.
After we performed. He played it the next morning, and I didn't pay him or say anything. I just said, I gave him the shit, and I said next time don't use this as a coaster.
Damn.
He laughed, he took it, and he played it the next morning. And from then, I was looking for the nigga like, yo. And he was like, yo, get your shit popping online. That was what he told me.
Yes,
I was annoying as fuck. He threw me off with that a little bit. I always wanted, I always wanted your praise, bro. I wanted his praise because he was like the big dog as far as like, me and Smarty would go to New York like almost every weekend. We was at a Fred One, shout out to Fred One's.
Fred One.
You gotta do Fred One's.
Yeah.
We would go to his studio, record shit. Or we record that Impact shit.
Mm-hmm.
And I was not the dude. I was kind of by the dude. Smarty was the dude. Back then. Like,
hold on, Smarty was?
Yo, wait, hold on.
Because, yo, I never really, like, yo, I fuck with Smarty, but I never. I always thought he was. You was more like. Advanced.
We're different in style. He's style.
It's, yeah.
I'm anger and lyrics.
So he's more like so. I feel like he's Juicy J almost.
So if you want to compare it, like,
yeah.
All right. A great comparison. Like, let's just say Griselda. Let's take Griselda.
Mm. Okay.
So Griselda.
Out of the three,
Smarty was West Side Gun.
Okay. Yeah. Right,
okay,
you know, but West Side Gun is kind of a Ghostface-ish sounding. But,
well, not just that. It's not just sound, but like West Side. To me, out of all of them, like out of all like three of them, he was just present.
I'm more like the Butcher.
Okay, so you're right.
I'm more like you're the right, Butcher
because you know Smarty, yo, when I watch it,
yo, like, he's gonna take the press. He's gonna take the air out of the situation.
Yeah.
And he knows, and he really enunciated his shit too.
Right.
He wants you to catch every line, right. Every way he says it. And right, okay. He wants you to catch that. He's style. He'll tell you all day. He's not, let him freestyle. He's going to murder you. don't get it twisted.
Yo,
nigga, I'm not a great freestyler. Right. I get it here and there. I'm a great writer. Like, let me sit down with a concept.
Yeah.
I'm going crazy. But, He's gonna kill it. The difference, I'm more like kind of like the Butcher. He's kind of like West Side Story.
West Side Gun. Yeah.
My bad. I'm fucked up. Yeah. But I always kind of was in there, and I always was like, yo, I need to. Because I remember he'd get the beats, and I'd get the other beats. He'd get the beats, and I'd be in the back like, all right.
Nah, but the
niggas, I don't think niggas really, 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 really started respecting my pen to already. If you want me to be 100.
Well, I mean, that was in your...
It's not my song.
In your peer group. Because niggas respected this shit. Like, because you're... Like, you got your peer group and then you had us. Like, we was like, oh, shit, P.O., you
but
know?
But you're not around... You wasn't around... You were around me. Yeah. So you're hearing what I'm doing. You wasn't around Smarty like
the collective.
I have mad crews that I'm a part of. Like boom, 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 yeah. Boom. Like this is my Bronx family.
Literally, how'd y'all meet though? Like
I met through a friend from the Bronx.
Impact.
Y'all ever did?
Shout out to Impact. I think he's on the West Side. I don't know.
Y'all ever did a joint together?
All right, so this is where we're going.
Okay. Are we going to talk about Queens?
We're going to talk about Boston. Oh, yeah, Queens, 45 minutes. 45 minutes.
That's
all
the
right.
Name of a song?
No. I was called the 45-minute king because supposedly I took 45 minutes to record 8 bars.
Oh, shit.
Yo, this pod is just to make me look crazy.
Perfectionist.
No, it wasn't a perfectionist. There's a difference.
He'll explain.
I'll explain. First of all, Jay, I'm way more confident in how I rhyme, what I rhyme about, and just myself right now.
Yeah.
Back then, I was not confident. I tried to be, but I was always, like, trying to get somebody's approval.
And the nigga was big. He had the weight on him. Now, I don't get it.
What? I was a fat mother. I used to get like that. Yeah,
that's what you was. And when you see the pictures, you're like, oh.
But I was I was the fat underground kid with the book bag on and the headphones.
You wasn't fat.
I was chubby. What the fuck?
Nah, you wasn't even chubby.
Yes, I was, bro.
Man, see, he looked. Look.
Whatever.
You was good.
Whatever. All right. Yeah. I'm cool now. Yeah. I'm cool now. But yeah. So we went out. I forget the spot in Queens. It was some suburban area. And y'all was like, yo, let's just do this song right now. Because you was making a beat. And you was like, yo, let's make this song. So we went to someone's studio in Queens. I forget. This is years ago. It might be 99, 2000. I don't forget. So it was years ago. And everybody had like 8 bars or some shit.
Oh, fuck.
You are fucking up. Move your foot, Timbaland. Yeah, you play. You do that. Everything goes shut down. Just leave it. All right, so we in Queens. We at your man's studio. I remember he brought, that's the first time I seen someone bring a guitar out and add to the beat.
Oh, he?
Yeah, he played a guitar. Yeah, he played a guitar.
Pardon me.
And I forget what my verse said, but it was 8 bars and it took 40, it didn't take 45 minutes. But y'all niggas said it took 45 minutes to fucking record. Yo, I remember, I was just thinking about that today, like, oh yeah, I forgot about that story.
Yo, that was one session.
They hated me. They hated me. Who paid for that session? I still owe you money for that?
Yeah, I don't know who paid for it, but it wasn't me.
Maybe it was Impact or somebody.
Yeah, it was.
Somebody paid for that
yo,
shit.
Yo, but that shit, that joint was crazy.
Because we jumped in somebody's car and went all the way out there. I don't know. We used to come to your crib. You used to be making beats. And we'd be like, y'all do this. So basically, it gets to one of the things I wanted to say off the board that I didn't get to say. Remember the time Dipset stole our song? Remember Dipset stole our song?
That Comes to Murder joint?
Alright. No. You, Jim Jones? Shit it up. No disrespect to Jim Jones.
Yeah, I'm like saying you make this nigga live out the road.
Nah, he live out here. He used to live down the road. I ain't fucking with nobody out here. What the fuck are you talking about? Alright, so this is the story. Mm-hmm. It starts in Boston. Tufts University, the mean streets of Boston.
Oh, Tufts University.
So, Adrian, wow. Shout out to Adrian.
AD.
AD. Tigrant Entertainment.
Wow.
Tigrant. I don't know how to spell that shit.
Yo. Yo, this dude said Tigrant Entertainment, yo.
That's what it was, right?
I know, but I haven't heard that.
You ain't heard in years. Yo. And I'm pretty sure he don't want to hear that shit in years.
Oh, man. I'm about to text him that.
Yeah, so you just got to text him Tiger Entertainment was spoken.
Yo. Hold on.
You hit him right now. Yo. All right, so.
I'm going to hit him right now.
So, out of nowhere, I don't know what song I had. Touch, Breathe, and Stop. I had mad creative songs, whether it was you liked it or not. I had songs about breathing, suicide, like it was just crazy. So Adrian, who was my manager, and I think Smarty's that manager at the time.
He was everybody's manager at the time.
He's just like, yo, all y'all nice, we all gone. So he had a connection to Tufts. I don't know if his girl or someone went there.
His girl went there.
He went there. So we did a show. We did a show there. And we all rode out to Boston. We spent the night out there. Did a show. Show was crazy. Niggas was trying to get it in with all the girls on campus and shit. I was stuck in some girl's room. It was some other shit.
For real?
Yeah. It was some Spanish girl, something like that. I think I was stuck in
there. They were all Spanish.
Yeah. It was a lot. It was a nice little area. We went back again, too. I forgot why or when, but it was somebody else's show. But anyway, boom. Real quick. So we at this show, and when we left, is I don't know why, but I think you were driving. It was me and Smarty. I think it was just me and you and Smarty. And for some reason, I don't know if you heard it or was on your mind, you was like, yo, I want to flip coming to America. It was in the car. Yeah, it was in the car. You had to think about it. It was in the car. So bust it. He was like, yo, we gonna flip it. I already know. And I remember this is how old school, nigga. We went to fucking Blockbuster to get the fucking We went to get the tape. No. This is how, nigga, we went and got the tape. Now, this is how Dipset, because this is have to be like 03. Because this is when the Dipset was coming out with all the compilations. Yeah, yeah. And I believe it's on the second one, right? So, bust it. We on it. We go straight from Boston to the Bronx. Nigga, go to Blockbuster, get the tape. However you got the tape to the audio, got that. You got it in the MPC. I remember you chopping it, boom, 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 boom. You chopping it. We still got that song somewhere. You chopping it, boom, 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 boom. We like, oh, word, we writing the verses. We writing the verses, back to back. We have verses like we go back to back, boom, boom, boom. Mm-hmm. What was our song called? Shit.
I remember the sample. God, I do remember.
Yeah, because you flipped it. It's the same sample that they flipped twice because they had to redo it to actually get it cleared. But where did we record this song at? In Queens. We went back to Queens. We recorded the song in Queens. You must have had a thing with this Queens studio. So we recorded it in Queens, and then I don't know what happened from there. We were promoting it, and I think you said you sent it to somebody. Mm-hmm. That
can master it.
That is that how it got into the Dip's hands? From what I understand.
That's I think what happens, I played it for them, man. I just kept it moving. That was it. That was
you played?
I just played just like a nice 15, 20. Not even. I played like a. It was longer than that. I played like a minute of it.
Just the beat?
No.
Or the song?
The song, yeah.
You played the song. So these niggas heard our shit, literally. Mm-hmm. And was like, oh, this shit is fire. We'll do it outside. So that what was it called? Coming, what the fuck they shit called it?
The coming attraction?
No, it was called Coming For You or some shit.
Come to America.
No, but it had DMX on it. DMX did the hook. Oh. What's really good?
Yeah.
That's
what
it is. So our song became Dipset's What's Really Good, because these niggas. Then the original version they had was good because they had the sample. The sample was what makes it what it is with the King Joffy Joe. I remember the end of it, you got Arsenio yelling and shit, closing the door. I remember all that shit. So, shit. So they did the whole thing, but then they couldn't put it out officially. So they had to have someone come and play it over. And that shit was weak. But I always wanted to tell that story because I was like,
that's some bullshit.
Yeah,
it was crazy.
At the time, it was like,
yo, we need some reparations on that shit.
You talk to your man Jim, you know him, right?
Right.
You know him. You know him, right?
Nah, man, we don't know him. We don't know him, Jim.
Yeah. Shut your mouth, nigga. Oh my God!
Yo, give me a lighter. You got a lighter?
Who got a lighter? Yeah, I got a lighter.
Thank you, sir.
What'd you say?
So what else?
Oh, go ahead. Okay. No, you good. It was. I don't know, at that time, I don't know, man. That's all I could say. Yeah, but you know, I've always been told that I've always been ahead of my time for what I did.
Do you remember what made you think of that sample out the blue? Because we came back from a show, and you must have heard something. Or saw it on TV before you left.
I probably saw the movie before I even drove with y'all to the show.
Yeah, because he was like, he was driving halfway through the Bronx. He's like,
and then I kept thinking was by when he came to America, and you know, the roads. And then I kept saying, like, yo, man, like, yo, these chicks look cold, yo. Like, they look cold.
Because they out in the Queens weather. That was really Queens they did. That was the real Queens.
Yo, but that's how it's supposed to be. The bitch is supposed to be cold.
You know this chick was in there too. From a Jamie Foxx show.
Oh, yeah. The one that plays, what's her name? The tall.
Fancy.
That was young Fancy.
Yeah,
very young Fancy. Yeah, that's
one of my favorite movies, actually. One of them.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with Coming to America.
Yeah.
And yeah, every classic movie has classic music. Remember the music. To have a classic movie, you need two things. Music that is epic and everybody remembers for whatever reason. and catchphrases that everybody remembers. That's it. And that's how you
like, it's a hard not life.
Yeah, like, you're like Annie.
Yo, you know what? I'll tell you this right now. And nobody's flipped it, and they probably will. Or maybe they did. Who knows? I don't, there's so many producers.
There's a lot of producers that probably watching this right now. So
seducers or producers?
What are you smoking, nigga? We are not. No, you're not coming back. No. Where's Ross? Shout out to Ross. You couldn't make it.
There's a lot of pretenders out here. That's why I said that.
Oh my God. Well, I mean, the ending of E.T. No, the bike. When they on the bikes. Yo, that fucking.
You gonna flip that?
To this day.
Don't turn the bike. Yo, you know which one I'm gonna flip right now? He's an island boy.
Oh, no.
I'm gonna flip that shit. Oh, why?
See? What happens when you let these motherfuckers in?
I'm gonna
in,
make him
try to do some professional shit. You talking about fucking Beavis and Butthead over here?
I know, right? You talking about chicken foot. They look like upside
chicken
down.
Chicken foot.
Upside down chicken.
They look like shit, chicken, yo. Foot with extra hair on it. It was hairy chicken foot.
Yeah, man.
Yo, like, but them niggas got shit that comedians, athletes, ain't. They got their own, like,
they got emoji. They got 15 shit. Minutes of whatever the fuck they doing in their
exactly.
Eye. They not staying, bro. My bro, what are you doing? Are you ashing it on the napkin? Nigga?
Man, here. You ashing somewhere.
Nah, nigga, I don't want that. I got my own shit.
All right. So, shut up. Okay, let's keep going.
Why don't you ask for the sponsors like you normally do?
Because I know we don't. Yo, all right. So due to technical difficulties, kind of lost our sponsors. But
not technical difficulties. They
closed.
They closed down. But it was not no bad situation. Just because the situation with the pandemic, and they had to move at the time. So it was.
But if it wasn't for your boy taking his hiatus and going to get a CDL. Now he can support
shit.
This show.
Now you want to talk this shit. Now you supposed to be Mr. Money and shit.
So now we good. We good. Now we got a show. My man's got a year in. He's phenomenal.
I did a year. You left me, nigga. The fuck?
We got all of these interesting artists that is helping our platform take it to the next level. So I'm good. I'm happy.
Yeah.
You know, man. So this is what it's all about.
I just want to thank this man for coming, because realistically, on some shit, we haven't had a talk, especially like this, in a while. So I was like, yo, come through. You know what I mean? And when I seen you at the cigar.
It's Smoking Ashes.
Yeah, no, Smoking Ashes.
Barbecue.
And the way it is, you got to get your niggas your flowers now.
Yeah, gotcha.
Oh, this shit, yo, this Young Dolph shit, like, even to the Nipsey shit, like, that shit is. I don't even know these niggas, and that shit hitting me like,
because it's going. It looked like somebody you know.
Yo, it's like, damn.
I just seen a clip. What's it? My son. He just put a clip, and I don't know if the guy is black, but the cops just shot a dude in a wheelchair multiple times.
See?
Multiple times for trying to enter a store.
That's why.
Multiple times. And I'm like, yo.
That's why you gotta stay with your shit. If you might as well stay ready, so you don't gotta get ready.
Get ready. Yeah.
So that's why we stay with our shit. That's what we promoting over here.
Okay. All right. So let's get
to it. Yo, you got your shit?
No, I don't got my shit. I got the claw. That's why I'm called Claw. I got the claw. that's it. Just stay 5 feet away from my asshole. You good. 6 feet away, right?
Nah, bro, it's a lot. All right, let's not get off a topic.
What's topic? Tell me. Talk to me.
Because when you started to get into that, and it made me think, like, yo, it's a lot of fucking distractions.
As we.
But it's okay, because, you know, we just need to surround ourselves with like-minded people and people that stop wasting our time with fucking people that just want to talk about it, you know? Mm-hmm. We gotta get around these people who are actually trying to make a difference, bro. Because you see a lot of people who know better, but they don't do better.
Right.
You okay. Know?
Right.
So when I meet people that's actually doing better and trying to push this so-called humanity forward,
mm-hmm.
man, I'm all with it, bro.
Okay. Virgil.
Look at this guy.
Virgil.
I mean, I really have been out the loop because I've been in my truck, but I heard about him. He's some type of famous fashion
Oh my god.
Yeah, I go on social media, I do my little, I was mad that I didn't know about him. Put it like that.
Well, he's pretty much become more famous in the last few years.
And that's fucked up. Why you gotta blow up when you...
Bro.
Nigga, you blew up when they go. Bro,
like, blowing up is just being famous to other people that might not know him. He's been doing things in the fashion world for some time now, and designer world for some time.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And the thing about it is nobody knew that he was sick, at least not everybody.
And that's that same shit with...
I know Chadwick. Yeah. Both. Some people don't want you to know, you know what I mean? They just want to do their work. And that's what it is.
And that's not fair, man.
Why? Because you
invest a lot in these people as far as emotions is real.
Bro,
that's the one thing that I'm fucking.
You don't know he ain't your friend or your family, so.
But it don't matter. Like you be like, oh shit. Like
you know what I hate when people say, yo, so and so died, yo, shit was ill, yo. I wish he was here so I could hear some more music. Nigga, what? His life is gone. Fuck music.
Yeah.
Fuck are you talking about?
But that's your value. Like but obviously a life is value, but yo, you bring so much more value through your gift.
Pass me the lighter.
Yes, you do.
So
yes we do.
Always admire the gifts and we forget about the not really forget about the person, but you live longer with your gifts. You live forever. When you really have that gift, you ain't dying.
This nigga talking like a psychic. Listen, this nigga talking like a psychic. All right, Kyle Rittenhouse. Last episode, I didn't know that he only killed white people, but I still don't agree with how he did it.
You just skipped over my man Virgil like that. You didn't even...
We
went off topic.
What you gonna say? You didn't even know him. You exactly. said you didn't know about him.
So I want you to let me know.
I don't know that much about him neither. Okay, I know he's no, I don't. I'm not a fat. I'm not a fashionista,
but we don't really.
No. This no disrespect. I'm not like a fashionista dude. I'm not like that high end shit. You see me? I rock fucking shirts with animated people on it all day. Like, I don't give a fuck.
Nah, but what I'm saying is, like, I'm rest in peace, but we really don't know. You know, I was looking for you to tell me.
He's smart because he's staying out of it. Right. No, he knows exactly what to do that. He got people he work, you know, in the industry. Fuck what you talking about. Kyle Rittenhouse.
I don't know about
the white boy. You don't know. You in your truck. He's in his truck all
that
day.
That nigga that shot the people with the AR?
Yeah.
Fuck that nigga, man.
He didn't shoot any black people.
Don't matter. Fuck
I'm just saying, I didn't know. I was misinformed, so I want to say I'm sorry about that. But still, I don't agree with how he went about it.
What? So he was in the crowd?
He said he went there to save his grandfather's business, some kind of business they had over there. Mm-hmm. But they went over there with the AR. So you go over there with the AR.
He was getting jumped and he just shot?
They said motherfuckers was trying to get at him. One
that was a fucking lie. That sounds like a nigga. He plotted that shit up. He knew wherever they was going to be. He showed up with the joint and he was dead.
I like the fact that Static knows his media training.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because if you don't really know, you know, whatever. But me, I feel like I got a little insight to how them motherfuckers work. Because I work with them motherfuckers. You know I'm in the industry.
Okay, what's your thoughts on the boosters? Or the moronic variant.
All of this shit is to pimp our emotions so we go out and do more dumb shit. Focus on us.
Ooh, okay.
We need to focus on us.
Okay, well, how are you focusing on yourself when they're saying, yo, I need to stick you with some extra shit so you can do everything?
Stack your money.
You can't go out. Say that you can't go out to dinner without getting this booster.
That's even better because you get the. You get to get your wife to cook, and you get to stay home, and you get to save your goddamn money.
You know damn well.
I mean, but what I'm saying, theoretically,
because
a lot of people are going to be like, fuck it, I'm going out, I don't give a fuck. But at the same time, it's like they're just trying to fuck with us. Like, I believe that the booster is some real shit, but like, we as people make this shit real.
Like, I mean, are we talking... So we talking like simulation talk?
Because we're already built with immune systems.
Yeah.
Some of our immune systems aren't up, so your immune system might not be up to par with mine. Mm-hmm. I'm supposed to go get a shot because you dropped dead right by me? Some people might get scared into doing that.
You could drop dead from anything.
But what I'm saying
is, listen. Lately, what I've noticed the pandemic did is it brought the 80s back. Because these motherfuckers out here is wilding the fuck out. You're from the Bronx.
Right.
You know.
And what aspect?
It's wild as fuck out there right now. It's always been wild.
When you say wild, what do you mean wild?
Wild, like, I don't give a fuck if there's cameras on every corner. I don't give a fuck if the boys is outside. I'm lighting this block the fuck up.
Oh.
Like, that, when you have that kind of mentality...
It's a young boy shit, right?
Well, yeah, but every young boy has their time. And the only difference with I think, the time I came up in the 80s into the 90s, the only difference is the niggas out there, for the most part, if they wasn't reckless, they was like, listen, don't hit no kids, don't try to hit no women. You know what I mean? If you're going to get somebody, get somebody. This is a wild, wild fucking West.
I don't hang around the type of bullshit, man. I can't really relate right now, B. I'm in my
truck. Because you in your truck.
I'm working.
I need to change this episode. He's in his truck.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, it's all about who you... So, with us, right? You're a music producer.
I am.
He stays behind the keyboard.
You surround yourself by like-minded people, so you might not be dealing with the same thing I might be dealing with. It's all about how you just move, man. Yeah.
That's true. I'm not saying that. Man. That's true. But you could move and something could just pop.
Yeah, and that's
just life.
And that's when you're ready.
That's what life. So y'all worried about boosters, nigga. I'm worried about just random shit popping up. I'm fine. My immune system is up to par. I ain't been sick for 4 years, nigga.
We good. Black people.
Straight up.
We as a people done.
I drink my liquor, I smoke my weed, and I take my time.
And you got your platform. I got my platform. As long
your platform is the truck.
But what I'm it don't matter. But what I'm saying is, if we stay in our lane, we good. It's when we try to be nosy and we try to...
Yo, what are we getting at, bro? I have mad shit to talk about all the goddamn...
About the booster.
All right, the booster's done. Fuck the booster. I'm done talking about Omarion and the booster.
It's not Omarion.
It's called the Omicron or the Galvatron or the Megatron.
I swear, these shits is like mixtapes.
Yo, when they came out with the Delta variant, I said, I knew another one's coming out. It's a sequel.
Let me get that.
You need a sequel.
That lighter, let me see that.
For what? King Richard. You seen it? King Richard?
I ain't see it.
I seen it the other day.
Yo, great. This nigga is great. Good movie. He got a bunch of bullshit out there. Dipset, Megatron.
We did the Dipset story already.
Already? All right.
You can't
see it.
Where we at, nigga? We talked about beat in the industry. We talked about Matthew Knowles. We talked about production and beats.
Yo,
we talked about
that, yo. That's
what the disrespect.
Yeah, with Matthew Knowles, man. That family is, you know,
it surprised him.
Kind of hard. You know?
Look. You coming from you coming and you coming from where you come from, and you dealing with the people you deal with. Cause let's talk about, you're very known in, like, I would say, the underground scene, right? Right, so you know everybody, like you said, you DJ for Immortal Technique.
Right,
shout out to Immortal Technique. I had a cypher with him one time years ago, but that's my old claim to fame. Claim to fame, nigga. So you're in this pocket,
mm-hmm.
and right now, what's the difference from what you would call the underground when we were coming up to now? Is it more structured? Is it more opportunities to get paid more? What is it? Because I'm an underground kid, but I always did commercial records. Let's be 100.
I mean, is it, what makes it commercial? That's the question.
All right, what makes my songs commercial?
No, I'm just saying, like,
what makes the game,
like, all right, I make songs that are structured for people that probably wouldn't know that I'm underground, if you want to be 100, unless I just spit a verse.
So you're just
I wanted to be popular so bad. Exactly. I wanted to be popular so bad. And I was like, oh.
Nah, but that's the thing. That's the problem, man. You saturate that shit.
Bro, I know. I understand.
I don't know, and I'm saying that.
Well, but this is a man grown into his 40s. I'm in my 40s. When you get into this
Yeah, but look what I just told you. I just dropped that gem about staying in our lane. You got your fucking lane. You good already.
Everybody just calls me a podcaster now.
You good. I'm telling you, you good.
Oh, man. Pull the podcaster. I was trying to get into some shit and he threw me off.
As fuck him, man. We talking about...
Fuck who? You don't say that to the guest, niggas.
No, I'm talking about fuck P.O. and getting thrown off. We celebrate my mans right here.
Nigga, smoke and your joint. This is smoke your blunt. Smoke it.
Anyway, but nah, I really want to know, have y'all ever did any songs together?
I did the original What's Really Good. I forget what we called that at the time because it's just...
You ain't have it brought up so we can hear that shit?
I would have to look for that.
No, I just wondered if you ever had
it. I'll find it, though. I'll definitely find that joint. Yeah. I have it in a crate somewhere.
That's crazy because I don't even have a copy of
that. Yeah, I don't really have it. I believe some old joints that, like...
Yo, those were cool, though. That's a disc or what shit on that... Yeah. All that, everything's digital, man. So if you didn't put it on into a digital scape, you don't have the machines to run it. It's funny having the machines to run it. Sound like goddamn NASA with their bullshit. But anyway, all flattering shit coming out of nowhere. Nah, but you can't play that shit. Like, you have to have those machines or you have to have it transferred digitally. It doesn't, you know what I mean? It wouldn't make any
sense. Yeah, I know. My cousin was doing that, trying to put all of his stuff, try to make everything digitally, and that's what it's going to. So
I want to, before I get out of here, before this is done, I want to shout out to Artist to Watch. I want to shout out to Rashid, his management group, Finex Entertainment, and I want to shout out to all the artists and all the actors that's on Zoo Burrow. I did a showcase last Saturday. It was Saturday. I thought it was Friday. Did a showcase last Saturday. And what are you doing? It's weed smoke. Leave it. Leave it. It's the ambiance. What the fuck are you doing?
I ain't gonna front. Whatever smoke is, it's
word, right? Yeah. You be around. Now, we go right back. You be around people that smoke all the time. Now, you're not a smoker. No. Never.
Well, I have.
You've had, but you just, and you know your limits and shit. Yeah. So he's good with that. But like I want to say, shout out to all of them.
I would offer, but we in the pandemic. You know how that shit is. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, everybody's smoking. But like I said, shout out to them. I had a showcase on Saturday.
Fucking bomb.
Yeah, I fucking threw up.
This nigga is rusty. Well,
you know, I wanted to say that I fucked up. I didn't want you to say I fucked up, but rusty. Yeah, I was rust. Nah, no, I forgot my words. I ain't gonna lie. I wasn't prepared.
He needed you, bro.
No. Yeah, he would have been looking at me like, nah. But
this guy here.
This is no excuse. I went up there just to have fun. Fucked up, but I still had fun. Promoted the pod.
Hold on, what songs did you do?
I did the newer song, so I'm not really in tune with performing them yet.
So you already have recorded it and had it everything.
I haven't structured the performance in my head, so I haven't gone through that enough. I gotta keep doing it. I like it this way because the one thing that it taught me, and this is all right, I think of it like a comedian, you have to bomb in order to get better. This happens. Yeah. It just is putting me in a point where I'm not comfortable. Like, yeah, I could kill any stage. So now I gotta be like, all right, I gotta get back in that zone. So I just gotta hit the next one. That's all it does.
Yeah, practice.
Yeah, that's all it does. But I wanna shout out to them. I had a great time out there. I wanna shout out everybody that had a good time. My man's at one. I'm definitely gonna get y'all on the pod. We're gonna structure something where we can get y'all on the pod. I wanted to shout y'all out. Thank y'all. And shout out my boy I of Ev Lee on Instagram. That was my photographer for the weekend or the week or whatever the fuck. That's where all the photos that you see me flooding your asses with, that's where he's the guy that took all the photos. So shout out to him. That was my little fall edition. Then in the wintertime, I think January and between February, I'm going to do a winter edition. So just do a little seasonal shit just to keep you up to date on the flyness. Mm-hmm. So that's basically it. You know what I mean? And shout out to Ra. Rylina, she couldn't make it. You know what I mean? She'd be busy. You know, like I say, always is a holiday season. Make sure you hit her up. Get beautifully broken. Boom, boom, boom. Let's make that happen. This is a good read. And the Audible is coming out next year, I believe, in January, she said. I need the Audible because I'm not illiterate, but I am a little bit off when it comes to reading because I get lost in the words. Yeah. Yeah. You got it? Did you read that yet?
Ain't nobody got that shit. Can nobody hear this nigga talking 5 miles a fucking minute?
Nigga, hey, you talk slow.
This nigga's like, yeah, buy the book. She wrote the book. They like the book.
I don't think they like you talking like that, bro. I think you should.
This is probably a good read.
It's probably a good read.
I'm saying I gotta read.
I would. You know what? I want you to do the Audible. Let's hear your ass read this.
Why you think so?
Start. First lines. No, in the book, bro. In the book. Read not the title.
Yo.
Give me the first line. For real, I swear to God, do the first line. This is.
I am not about to read this book to you.
No. Read it out loud. You want to do comedy? You had to start somewhere. Read the first couple lines. Let me see how you would get up.
This is not comedy, bro. I don't even know.
It doesn't make it comedy, nigga. No,
This says beautifully.
No, I didn't say that at the title, nigga. I said give me the first paragraph of the first page.
I'll read it to myself.
No, it's not funny then. The fuck is it?
So you're trying to say I'm funny when I read?
Yes, nigga.
You haven't even heard me read before.
I know, and I'm guessing it's funny. So
this guy's, I'm going to smack him with this book. That's
Go ahead, that's funny. I don't give a fuck.
This is my cousin's book. Go get this book, yo. I ain't gonna hit him. I'm not gonna hit him with this book. I'm gonna hit him with another book. I'm just looking for it.
Yeah, whatever. There ain't no book to talk about. Man, ain't no book.
Beautifully broken. Yo, you crazy,
Nah, before we go out of here, before anything, you are here today and I wanna thank you for coming.
Mm-hmm. Yo, let's start over.
Wait, no, bro. It's no starting over with podcasts. This is never. He wasn't supposed to be here today. He was not supposed to be here today. He was supposed to be here last episode, not this one. This one, I was like, my man's here. We got a lot of history.
You didn't tell me.
What?
And you gotta keep going through the history. That's what I'm saying. Let's keep going through the history.
I brought up stuff that he obviously forgot and was like, listen, that's a done time in my life. I don't want to rethink about all that shit. Y'all motherfuckers. I do remember Smarty killing shit.
How the fuck you remember? Yeah, that was like,
my memory is sharp.
Like
I remember things like it was last week, bro.
At least 10 years ago?
Yeah. I told you my first memories is fucking watching E.T. and fucking Return of the Jedi. And that's 83.
When he said E.T., I was like, damn. Yo, I've seen that, but I can't even remember.
I remember watching that shit. That's 83. Yo, 82, 83, I remember that far back. So you tell me, like, if something happened, remember the time I almost fought Adrian in the street? Was you there? No. On Adrian? I didn't get Adrian on here. He'll fucking be talking. Well, crazy shit about me. Nah. Like, yo, you were such an asshole, man.
You?
Yeah, but he was one too.
He's from the Bronx. He think he a tough guy.
Bro. I never said I was a tough guy.
He think you though.
No, I'm not a tough guy.
You don't say it, but the way you.
I don't back down. I won't back down if I know I ain't gonna die.
It's like a retard. It's like a retard, yo. He's not gonna think about shit until.
I used to have when I was young. I used to have I kind of still do, but I used to have a very very bad temper. That's why we moved out here. Because I was always getting into fights. So, I don't want to fight because I know how far I will take it. And I want to keep what happens. So, that's why. But that's why I talk to you crazy. Because I know you're not going to do nothing but give a bear hug. You're not.
See, that's why I be trying to warn this nigga. Nigga, this nigga, yo, I will pistol with this nigga and he don't even know it.
I mean, he could, but...
But that's my boy, though. Like, I'm sick of doing that shit, yo. You know how many niggas I done fucking fucked up? And that's been my boy because he, like,
trying to cross... Yo, remember... All right, real quick. Remember the time we almost fought Neff? Or I almost fought Neff?
Nigga, I
don't know. I had to yell at that Neff nigga crazy.
My boy.
I had to yell at him because he would get drunk and we'd be in the city. And yo. I'm like, bro, don't have me do this. Like, come on, man.
Yo, we all, yo... Back in, yo, that's what I'm saying. Like, yo, back in the day, like, every time we can talk, yes, shit went down back in the day.
I talk crazy, but I will back it up if need be. I just don't want to. I really don't.
It's no need to get to that. Nigga, all we focus now on this.
Why are we having this conversation?
Right. Nah, because I want you to know that.
I know, he's like, this is a podcast. Y'all niggas is
I mean, I'm having fun.
This nigga's speaking in sign language, right?
I'm having fun.
Look, me, I'm talking to my mans. I ain't seen him in like 6 months. And, you know.
He really ain't seen me in that long.
Literally. So, you know, I'm respecting the fact that, you know, y'all, we got, you know, but
no,
I'm still trying to incorporate a lot
of shit. No, I know you. It's, this is a great episode.
But I ain't supposed to be here, you know. But I'm here, nigga. He didn't think I was going to show up.
Shout out to all my side people, I ain't wearing that.
I'm on some real shit. Yo, my nigga, I really, really wanted him to do this podcast.
He did. I ain't gonna lie. He told me to do it because I wasn't gonna do it because I'm super overthinker, perfectionist. And I wasn't gonna do none of this shit. But
and look, yo, so many people been on this in this platform, yo. We can't, like, it's crazy. Like, I wouldn't even thought, like, two or three people, and it's been mad people. So, it's like, I had to step away from my whole CDL thing.
Man, this guy, whole life, he got a whole trucking business. Nah, this nigga don't need to come back.
Nah, at the same time, yo, it's my passion. It's my passion to fucking, like, you know, like celebrate, like, hear people's stories and be able to have a platform to where they could, like, show people that, like, yo, because some people sit around thinking, like, yo, it's over, it's it.
I told you the last few years of my life has been a great little way of figuring out who I am. I forgot who I was some years back, because I wanted to be popular and wanted to be in front of everybody. I used to run up on motherfuckers, yo, listen to yo, man. Run up on everybody.
Now it's like, fuck them, because yo, people...
Now I'm just like, man, you want to come, I'll figure a way to, you know what I mean, entertain myself.
How about you, yo, don't you think, like, you know, like, as far as you working with people, like, do you really, be, like, some, like, you don't get everybody the time of day, right?
Nope. No. Exactly. He'll cut a nigga off.
Exactly. It be like that, yo. You start to learn, like, yo, your time is valuable. You really have something to offer the universe. Like, letter. You just gotta. Everybody can't come. Everybody.
I'm talking about letter. All right, real quick before I said before he's. I'm happy you came out here today. I know you're a busy man. You're not so necessarily around, but you are around. You're kind of guy that's around, but not around at the same time. But I know tomorrow makes, I believe, a year that one of our brothers, one of our fellow producers, fellow DJs, mm-hmm. Asa Buchanan.
Dang.
R.P. Asa Buchanan.
Don't even say that.
Yes. He passed sometime last year, I believe, around this time, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. When it happened, I didn't know exactly what happened and how everything was moving. It was really abrupt. I had just probably talked to him online. I was really trying to get him on here too, to just kick it. He's one of the dudes that I met through the beat battle scene. And believe me when I tell you, he was the absolute life of the party on some real shit. He was a dude that never had a problem smiling and finding your way. He would always be like, yo, yeah, yo, I fuck with you, yo. He does that club shit, but I fuck with him. He was like, he does that club shit, but I fuck with him. I know what you're doing, yo. He always would tell me that, man. I want to give biggest condolences to his family, his friends, everybody that loved him. His brother, Ak, you know what I mean? There's a year memorial service tomorrow, right? I believe. Mm-mm-mm. No?
My bad, bro. I'm just thinking about like Asa.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It don't seem like it's real. On some real shit, it don't seem like it's real. But I believe there's a memorial service for him tomorrow at the earlier in the day. It's
at the lodge.
The lodge on T-Net Cedar by off of Cedar Lane.
Yeah.
American. I forget what they call it.
American Legion.
American Legion. We used to go there for parties when we was in junior high back in the day. That's what they used to throw parties for us back in the day like that.
Like from 7 to like midnight or probably to 2 in the morning, we'll be in Smoking Ashes. I'll be spinning.
Yeah, he'll be spinning at Smoking Ashes and Tina tomorrow. I'm going to try to make that. I'm working tomorrow. I'm going to see if I could dip out, but I'm definitely going to try to make that. For me, and this had nothing to do with me, was just being selfish, but I was kind of mad that I didn't find out when everything was happening. Where it was or what was going on and shit like that. Mm-hmm. So I want to dedicate this episode to Asa Buchanan, to Ock, to his whole family, to his friends, to his son. You know what I mean? Gone way too soon. He's a fellow producer, DJ, artist, friend, brother. You know what I mean? Like, for real. I'm going to get this motherfucker's picture up on the wall, too. I got to get a good picture of him up on the wall. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure that I said something and got my respects out for him because I could hear his fucking voice right now. I remember last time I seen him was at, he had a birthday party. Well, when he moved to Jersey, I was like, you out here? You right down the block. Mm-hmm. So he was like in Hackensack or right by the hospital and all that. And he used to go to the cottage.
Yes, the cottage.
Yeah, I would see him at the cottage, and we kick it, da-da-da-da-da. That's where Danny was DJing at the college. Shout out to Danny, Dan C.E., my cousin. Mm-hmm. I got to have him up on here. He just got my mama's sweet potato pie, so he ain't listening to shit. that's where one of the last time, but I think the last time was maybe a year or two before, but it was before COVID, maybe a year or two before COVID. He had a birthday party in New York, downtown somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And I came there. That's last time I seen Impact. Shout out to Mark, sis Karen. R was out there. Mm-hmm. Adrian was out there. Faye, shout out to FaZe. FaZe One, my brother.
He has a song that's out.
The Sorry Joint? Is that it or is that a whole other song? Because I was listening to this, the one you put up.
Yeah, on my page. That's the one that just dropped, yeah.
Yeah,
man. Shout out to my man Doug Z on the production. But yeah, and that face joint, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
It's pretty dope.
Shit, man. But yeah. Yeah, I just want to give my respects for him right there. But is there anything you would like to say, sir? Anything you would like to get off your chest? Say anything, what you got going on, coming up?
No, I ain't going front. I mean, you know, I ain't going front. Like, I be having early mornings, late nights.
You be in the stew. You be.
Yeah. You know, so sometimes sleep for me is just.
You going to be up working on.
I got this from here. I'm going home.
You going home because you got a day tomorrow.
Yeah, I got a long day tomorrow. Yeah, I gotta see my bed, you know what I'm saying?
Get that comfort. You know, you gotta get that comfort.
Yeah, I gotta get that comfort. I gotta get that bed right, you know what I'm saying? I do wanna shout out Session In.
Okay.
My bro Session In on Battle Lab. I mean, usually every other Friday we have a theme night where every producer from all over basically creates. Like, say, like, if today is EDM, okay. House, though, everybody.
Yeah, I see you've been on that.
Yeah, it's pretty dope. So, you know, shout out to everybody on there. And I know I was supposed to actually, time is it 10:10? Yeah, so I should actually be saying something for them. But I got to go to the crib and play because I can't play it from my phone.
You got to go to the crib so you get that quality of it.
Quality.
Yeah, this is the dude that he would literally. He's the first of all, we didn't really get into the beat battle part real quick. Mm-hmm. Like we went into the beat battle, but shout out to Rocky.
Rocky and Mike.
Rocky and Mike. Oh my God, Mike G.
Mike G, yeah.
Where's Mike G?
I don't know.
I think I seen a recent picture. Shout out to Mike G. Mike G was one of the first dudes that always, I think I had Pow Wow. And I remember he loved Pow Wow. He used to rep for me all the time. Shout out to Mike G. Back when I didn't know what the fuck I was doing, he was like, yo, yeah. Swear to God, you gotta, you know, show up for the motherfuckers that see something in you before you see something in you. So, shout out to Mike G, you know what I mean? And I used to love B-Bounds, man. That I used to love, like, ooh, even if I didn't win. Matter of fact, I'm right behind you. I did some slum. I had my own little 2004 little, you know what I mean?
A little black.
Shout out to Rocky for that. And
Where they host that shit at, though?
It used to be at the New Eurekans. They don't do B-Bells anymore. So Rocky went to, like, Austin or Texas or some shit.
Or, like, Arizona.
He went and followed DMX to Arizona. It was a joke. Because he's passed away, so I want to make sure you know it was a joke. Real quick. I had this idea, I told you, R's brother, I don't know if he still have any of the old footage of stuff he had, because I remember I always used to bother his brother, like, yo, where's the footage for the interviews and stuff? I want to start a script for an actual beat battle movie or series or something that we could all put our heads together and make some for that time period. It was like, what, 02 to 05 or something like that? It was like that little structure. It was like a whole community that would gather every month to the New Eurekan. And I'd be the only motherfucker there with a PlayStation.
With the TV.
And a small black and white TV.
Crazy.
I would, and they would joke on me. They'd be like, oh, you playing Tekken, nigga? You play Street Fighter? And I press play on that bitch. And nigga'd be like, okay. They get quiet a little bit. Just a little bit. He got that low. I battled him. Maybe once or twice. I think I battled him, but yeah. I was like, I knew I'm not gonna get it. Your drums is fucking crazy. Yo, he can play a drum and the whole shit be over with.
This motherfucker really showed up to a beat battle with a PlayStation.
You don't understand how much
PlayStation 1, right?
1 and 2. But we 2 is what got me to where I had to go. One of the first beat battles I had was like probably the one.
I wish I could have heard that shit. Why bro, didn't they take that shit, nigga?
There is video of it, but we don't know where the videos are, bro. Shout out to my boy.
And it was like official
Captain. Well, I still call him Captain Planet, but
yo, but it was official. Or it was just somebody put together.
What you talking about?
Like the beat battles. They official.
They
like,
were official beat battles. These are early 2000 beat battles. You know what I mean? Where you would come with your MPC, your keyboard, your Triton, whatever you had. I'm trying to remember all the stuff. Like, they would come with keyboards and all types of official shit.
Where, though? In New York?
Yeah, New York. It's a club called New Eurekan where they do poetry, rap, shit like that, spoken word.
Damn, that's crazy.
And we would get a, they have tables and they have the whole plugins and everything. The quarter inches I had to come with. You know what I mean?
What's a quarter inch?
Quarter inch is a big knob, right, that connects to the system.
Yo.
No, it connect, am I lying? It's a big knob that connects to the system. It has two other wires that connects to your white and red wires.
And then that plays your music?
Yeah, it was like an aux cord, nigga.
Yo, that's crazy.
It was an aux cord for the fucking system. Am I lying? It's an aux cord for the system. Bro, I had to buy shit. I used to walk around with book bags and big shit. I look like every day. I
was a nerd, nigga.
I was a super nerd.
Where the fuck was I, nigga?
I was
shooting guns.
You was shooting girls, guns, getting seven degrees.
Yo, this thing is stupid, but I'm like, nah, yo, I respect that, my nigga, because this nigga, like, you know, you was really on some low-key underground. I'm underground.
Okay, at the end of the day, I started rapping and rhymes came from Wu-Tang. I start from there.
So you watched that whole, you know that whole something Chambers.
36 Chambers?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. See, I haven't even heard all that shit.
Like, that's my first introduction to hip hop. Before then, it was just music. Okay. Like, I used to listen to Criss Cross, TLC, whatever my sister was playing, just whatever on the radio.
Okay.
But when I got into hip hop, it was Wu-Tang, it was Nas, it was Redman, it was Busta Rhymes. You know, it was early to mid 90s hip hop. That's how I started. So everything, even if I say, oh, I'm doing this catchy Elmo shit. Yeah, it's catchy Elmo shit, but it's bars in that Elmo song. It's bars in that already. It's bars everywhere I go. It's bars in here. Because that's my mind. It's like, I gotta have bars. I used to make beats so I could play them. And it'd be like, you think it's a whole human being. Like, I wanted to give it charisma, character.
Yeah.
Like, I wanted, like, that's what the beat battles did. Because you could flip it. You could just have this little loop here and flip it, chop it up, and come back to the loop and have a little audio here.
Because there wasn't no song behind it.
It wasn't set up to be a song with you to rap. It was to present your music and to make it as big as possible.
But did you have it on, like, crazy big-ass speakers and shit?
It was connected to crazy big-ass speakers,
That's
I would make them in my room and I would double up the drums.
We got a movie right there. You know that movie that they did about the Uptown? You know Uptown?
Yeah, I know what you're talking about when that came on Netflix.
Nigga, you got a whole movie.
Yeah, I know. That's why I want to get some of the people that was the forefathers of that together to, like, structure it. Now, I want it
so
just
who
to
were
be,
you all? Cause you
I
want to
be just around me. I want to be around.
And who was it?
You talking about the Zulu nigga? No, Shaka Zulu! We're done! Fuck! He said Shaka... Did you call the Zulu Nation Shaka Zulu?
No.
Did you call the Zulu?
No.
Yo,
I said Shaka Zulu, but I was just referring to some other shit. Fuck you, nigga.
Your hip-hop card has been revoked. Shout out to
what?
The...
Yo, I'm from the country,
shout
man.
Shout out to the six people that's watching.
I'm trying to get info. You seem like a very informative-ass nigga, so I'm talking to you.
Why you? Relax, nigga.
My bad.
What was that about? It's Friday, but... Because
I want you to understand, you need to sit down
shit
and
like
keep it going, you know?
Shit like that, you know, you get a busy bottle with that, nigga.
No, fuck.
Busy bottles all around, nigga.
So come on, look, this nigga like applesauce.
Yeah, I do like applesauce.
Send
nigga.
Up some fucking applesauce.
I like applesauce, nigga. You trying to play me? In my spot, nigga? That's what it's there for. I have to be a nice little set.
All right, come on.
I think
we... All right, so... I mean, we good, but yo, you helping me. Because I ain't know you like this, nigga. I ain't know you was really underground like that.
Yeah, because you know me from all the other stuff.
Yeah.
But see, still to this day, I could do that, and my underground peers would be like, that's still P.O. Because I was still doing that type of stuff.
Word.
Then it was just different.
But now you got to conform to the whole...
I'm underground to the death. I love... rapping and hip-hop and beats. Sometimes I'm not in the mood to do that record, but I have them. You know what I mean? Like, it's nothing there.
I feel you.
Yeah. What was your favorite beat I ever made? 1, 2, 3? Everybody says 1, 2, 3. Or the Died in Your Arms.
Yo, we gotta hear that hip-hop. Yeah, I mean, we gotta hear that Elmo.
No, nobody gotta
hear that Elmo. My favorite was that Elmo. I know it's stupid, but at the same time, it was like kind of like...
It's creative.
Yeah, exactly.
But I sampled Elmo from the toy and put him on there. Yeah, I definitely sampled Elmo.
Killed it.
And I took the drum track from Chicken.
But then you got the other one that y'all actually shot a movie. Like, this studio that he uses, you remember you turned it into a fucking...
Got me club with the girls.
Yeah, hell yeah.
I told you, it was Got Me... Was that Got Me Leaning? No, it wasn't Got Me Leaning. Got Me Leaning was when I wake up and then I go outside. That was Optimus High.
Exactly. Go look that up.
I did
Optimus High.
Optimus High, and then I had the stripper pole.
That right there, how you write.
I'm creative. You give me something, I'll figure a way to make something out of it. Right. You know what I mean? That's just what I do. But I think that's everything for the most part. I mean,
this nigga's tired. Let him go to sleep.
No, nigga, shut the fuck up. What the fuck are you doing there, man? I think we ain't talking about nothing but food shortages, but you look like you been eating, nigga, so fuck that.
Nah, so
you just came from eating.
I went to No Chase, Columbia, y'all got it.
Look at them, club and shit. Look, we're done. Say your piece, fuck out of here.
They about to be our sponsors, man, they good.
Say your piece. Say your motherfucking piece.
Nah, it was good coming back. Thank you for the invite, man. Much love.
Invite. This nigga hit me up all day while I'm at work. Yo, man. Nah. I love you too, bro. I love you too, man. Static.
Yo.
You good, brother?
I'm good.
Nah, you had fun?
Very nice to meet this guy.
I'm glad you had fun.
I had fun.
I'm glad you had fun. Hopefully everybody over there has fun. You know what I mean? I want to thank everybody again. This is the beginning of the third season because I just keep jumping around. Fuck that. We're in 400.
Yeah, because you be making up numbers. This nigga, I swear to God, yo, he just be making his own numbers.
Let me tell you something, though. People believe this shit.
I mean,
perception is the best. Perception. The guy at the show, he was like, yo, you got mad episodes. 400 or something. I said, yeah, I really got 28, but I just made y'all, think that shit.
That's what you
gotta do, man. Shout out to everybody. Peace. DJ Static, thanks for coming. Appreciate it, brother. I'll see you soon. You know what I mean? RIP to Asa. Shout out to my brother, Jonathan Maxwell, aka VA, whatever the fuck. Trey's gonna see this and be like, why the fuck you got this nigga back on?